Just keep paddling.
Hello, welcome back to 340 Paddler, and today we want to deal with safety boats, which, as AI advances, I can only imagine that this is the future of the 340. But before we get into that, let's talk about the actual safety boats on the 340. They are going to be all over the place. You're going to see them at every checkpoint, every paddle stop, many of the ramps, and during the race. If you're up towards the front, you won't see them that often. If you're in the pack, you will see them much more because, of course, they're going to try and keep that pack together, and of course, they have more paddlers there to take care of. And the safety boats will have one thing in common, which is a yellow flag on the back. Now, this yellow flag is particularly important. It tells you that that is a safety boat, not some random guy in a John boat. Now, obviously, people in Missouri are friendly. If you pop up to a guy in a John boat, he might be willing to help you out. But yeah, look for the yellow flag. And they are everywhere. There are roughly 20 safety boats that will be on the race. I apologize for the quality of the photo. It is an old photo, and people don't take pictures of these things and send them to me. So send them to me, and I can update the photos. But there are a lot of safety boats. Early in the race, early in the history of the 340, we had Scott Mansker, also known as our fearless leader, or the leader of Mansker's minions, of which I count myself as one. But he would go out there with the Osage Warrior, this fantastic sort of half canoe, half fishing boat, and run down the river like this, standing up, making sure everyone was safe. Today, of course, things have advanced well beyond that. And so we have to deal with how to interact with the safety boats. And this is where signaling comes in. If a safety boat gives you a thumbs up, what they are looking for is for you to do the same. Now, this could happen at inopportune moments. For example, you could have stopped to pee in the boat, obviously in a bottle in the boat or something like that. But I digress. If they signal you, they're trying to make sure that everything's okay, that there isn't a serious problem. What they're looking for is a thumbs up in return. If you don't give them a thumbs up, they're going to come over and start asking questions and talk to you a little bit, and it may slow you down, it may be inconvenient, it may be something that you just don't want to deal with at that time. Now, if they give you a thumbs up and you wave at them, that might be all right. It sort of depends on the day and the circumstances, if they're out looking for you, or how badly things look from their perspective. If you start waving your arms like a maniac, they're definitely going to come over and check. If you start, you know, doing semaphore with various large paddle items, they will come over and check on you. And this is the universal signal for, please come and check on me. I may or may not be dehydrated. So, how do you contact the safety boats? Let's say you're a ground crew and your paddler is very, very late. Or you are a paddler and you think you're in trouble. You will get a safety card. Now, I have noted this is 2014 safety card. So these numbers are no longer valid. There's always new information every year. You will get a safety card at registration. And it is waterproof. This is the sort of thing that your ground crew should have one or two that are sitting with them. And you should have one in the boat, somewhere that is easily accessible, but yet attached to the boat, or better yet, attached to you. I often recommend that you fold this and you put it in your phone case so that it's with the phone. You're not going to lose it. And you will see if you need help, there's a phone number there. In this case, in 2014, it was a phone number for Scott Mansker. You need to keep that number on you. I highly recommend that whatever that number is for this year, that you go ahead and pre-program it into your phone. And you'll notice there's frequently a second number. Pre-program that too. And just put help, help one, help two, or something, or safety boat one, safety boat two, safety boat three. Doesn't matter, but have it on you. Now, the safety boats do more than just rescue people and dishearten them in the form of the Reaper. They also have emergency supplies. you can expect that they will provide you, for example, with water if you run out. Now, if they keep running into you and you keep not having water, that will be an issue. But if it's, you know, hey, I missed my ground crew at the last stop, I don't know where they were, or hey, it's a lot hotter than I was expecting, they will provide you with water. They may even provide you with Brondo, because it's what plants crave, or something with electrolytes. But don't count on that. Not every safety boat has that. They don't have beer. I should point that out, because I believe at least once I have requested beer from a safety boat on night three, and that is a tricky situation when they say, are you hallucinating? And you go, no, of course you would have beer. So when you're out there struggling through night two or night three or whatever the situation is, know that you have a bit of a guardian angel, someone watching over you apart from various world governments who are there to help you if something goes wrong. You need only reach out and make sure that you respect them along the way. You can also feel free to ask them questions. You can feel free to approach them or signal to them to come closer. They're there to help. This is what makes the 340 such a fantastic race. So thank the safety boat crews. Until next time, this is 340 Paddler, hoping that you keep your paddle in the water.